more ugly elementary school student. I have great expectations for myself. I accept the challenge to become the best student I can be. I'm proud of my school. The vision of Oakview is promote a higher future and climate to inspire our community of learners to achieve academic excellence. I accept the responsibility for my behavior and its results. I determine to be safe, responsible, productive, and respectful. I have high excellence for myself, and I reach my full potential. I choose to be great.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Get ready for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone. Get ready for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone, for that Georgia milestone.
Pop by and see Principal Waters, all scholars who attend school all week long. That's right, if you have perfect attendance this week only, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, then this Friday you will pop by in the front lobby and see Principal Waters to get your special treat from 1:15 through 1:45 p.m. Students must attend school Monday through Friday. We want you to be at school every single day, have that perfect attendance, and have a great day, Oakview. We want to give a big shout out and announce the most improved students for the month of February. In pre-K from Ms. Johnson's class, Anthony Saar. In kindergarten from Ms. Edensberger's class, Carson Wright. And from Ms. Sampson's class, Ashir Barnes. In first grade from Ms. Weems' class, Skyla Lewis. In second grade, in Ms. Ligon Smith's class, Layla Walker. In Ms. Bozeman's class, Chandler Walker. In Ms. Monsanto's class, Dylan Espino. In Ms. Montgomery's class, Cameron Johnson. In Ms. Rhodes' class, Azaria Jackson. In fourth grade, from Ms. Izami's class, Jaceon Davis. From Ms. Pollard's class, Amaya Battle. In fifth grade, from Ms. Deadweiler's class, Tanila Mazion. And from Ms. Moore's class, Nariah Reynolds. Congratulations to all of our most improved students for the month of February. Oakview, this is our author spotlight. Today we're learning about Kelly Starling Lyons. Kelly Starling Lyons was born and raised in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. As a young child, her creativity was inspired by visits that she and her brother took to productions at the Children's Theater with their mother and the many nights she spent making up bedtime stories. Her grandparents taught her old school dances, sang gospel songs with her, cooked and gardened. Ms. Lyons' decision to become an author took place during her high school years when she developed a love for the writings of Richard Wright, Lorraine Hansberry, and Ralph Ellison. Check out some of her books, A Girl Named Misty, Ellen's Broom, and Hope's Gift. The book fair is coming, the book fair is coming, the book fair is coming. Save the dates from February 16th through February 23rd. Don't forget to ask your parents to set up your e-wallet, which allows you to shop. Friends and family can even contribute funds. Your parents may also visit the book fair during the after-school hours and make payments using a credit card from 2:30 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. daily. A teacher preview day will be held Friday, February 16th, 2024. Teachers will receive a $5 off a $25 purchase coupon at their visit. Thank you to our Oakview Beta Club for sponsoring a book fair in their initiative to promote reading. The month of February is Black History Month. Here are our celebration events. Each class will decorate right outside their class with a Black History person. Leave it up for the month of February. The best dressed wall will get a prize. The Media Center will have biographies of Black History leaders on display in the Media Center all month. You can come in and choose your person to put on your wall whenever you like. We would love to see these displays go up immediately. On Tuesday, February 13th, we are asking all staff and students to dress in African attire. On February 19th, everyone will create a Black History poem. The top poem from each class will be displayed in the Media Center. In the week of February 26th, we are asking teachers to play African music or any historical relevant music to the culture. slave hymns, and so on. Grandparents and Beta Club members will come to the class this week to read Black History books. We also want the staff to get involved. On February 28th, we are having a soul food feast for the teachers and faculty and staff only. Teachers, please look out for the sign-up list so you can say what you're going to bring to culminate our Black History Month celebration.